Hey guys, Corey coming at you here from Georgetown, Texas. Welcome back to Carpet Muscle TV here. Getting ready to do some tile. It's a kitchen and a laundry room as well as two bathrooms. So basically what I'm gonna do in this video is show you probably what I feel like is the easiest way to do it. Damn sure the least expensive. And you know, a lot of people feel like they need, you know, high pressure to do tile and grout cleaning. And I used to think the same thing too, you know, but tile and grout cleaning was done long before there was truck mounts and long before there was spinners and high PSI cleaning. All of that was around long before that. Basically what I found through the years is that you don't need any PSI whatsoever if you have your chemical right. The chemical's gotta be strong enough. I found out just the other day that I found a chemical that worked really well on grout, and it cost a dollar, and it's less toxic than using Forest Stripper. Forest Stripper is about the strongest you can get, you know? And it's a 14 basically on the pH scale, whereas what I'm gonna use today comes in at about an 11. So I'm gonna show you what I'm gonna use as far as cleaning chemicals, and I'm gonna show you the machines I've got to choose from. I may use a shop vac in the kitchen, but in the other areas in the two bathrooms, I'm just gonna use basically light agitation and a towel. And before I'm done with the video, I'm trying to not leave anything out, you know, so nobody thinks that they can't do this, you know, either for themselves at home, or if you wanna start a small business and do this. It's just a matter of wanting to get the job done right. You don't need a lot of money to do that. So let me start the video. This is what I'm cleaning with today. LA's totally awesome. This cost a dollar. Dollar Tree. Everybody's seen this stuff around. I've laughed at it for years and years and years and years until I had a veteran cleaner tell me how well it works. And the main reason why I've laughed at it for so many years is because of all the things that it says it cleans. Now, theoretically, you can't get somewhere on here, I think it says rust. Okay, well, you're not going to get rust out the same thing you get everything else out with. A lot of this stuff on here basically will come out with a high pH cleaner, but you're not going to get rust out, so I call bullshit on rust. To get rust out, you need oxalic acid, and basically you put the oxalic acid on it and it makes it disappear. And I recommend Wink, W-H-I-N-K, Wink rust stain remover. That's what I use, and it costs at least $2. And this guy, Clear Volume 20, which is 6% hydrogen peroxide. This is a salon grade product. I get it from Sally Beauty Supply. And I'm gonna neutralize everything with plain old vinegar, just vinegar. That's the three components that I'm gonna use today here. So let me show you what I've got to choose from here. And I believe what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use probably the Oreck. In most cases. I've got this brush here that goes under the Challenger if I feel like I need it. I don't feel like I need to break the Challenger out. And I've also got this guy I bought a couple of weeks ago. This machine is 50 years old. I paid $125 for it. This is one I brought for it today. I bought the brush. And this being an old Clark machine, it doesn't have your typical clutch plate on it, basically. It's got a different one. So at home, I've got one of my subscribers, a really good buddy of mine, sent me just this piece here, which has been out of production for a long time. He knew where to get one because he cleans with one of these. He sent me one of these, and then I ordered just your 12-inch driver to go underneath it. And I'm gonna basically retrofit that out maybe later today where I can turn just your typical pad driver with that. And I'm gonna try doing carpet with it because he does carpet with these guys and I do carpet with this. And I'm gonna see in the next couple of weeks how effective I can make this work because he does a wonderful job and uses this. It just depends on basically what you're used to. You know, if you clean with this and somebody tells you that that won't work, then you're gonna do everything in your power to prove them wrong. And it may take a little longer, but I don't really give a damn. He does wonderful work with just this machine here. I think he's got, since he started watching my channel, he put away his truck mount, pulled out two of these, and has been doing BLM ever since. Because that's how he started out 40 years ago using these guys.
I think you got a new one here recently, a new used one, that is. I prefer used equipment if you can find it. This guy here, I don't think I'm going to use it today, but I am a dealer for this machine. So I feel really, really strongly toward this machine here. And this is the brush that goes under it, and it does a hell of a job of agitating. Problem is when you agitate big giant agitation in a small area, you wind up wearing it, you know? So if you get off in this kitchen here or in some of our bathroom with it, you know, it'll try to fling it up all on the counters and everywhere else, not on the counters basically, but the bottom of everything. It'll try to throw stuff everywhere. So this is one of the areas that I'm gonna be cleaning. And this one I may actually use a shop vac to pick up some of the liquid with. Now the other two areas are much smaller. They're bathrooms. All they're gonna get is an agitation and a towel. So basically what you're gonna see me do is you're gonna see me spray down the clear in here, let it dwell for about 15 minutes. I'm gonna agitate it with the Oreck and the brush, then let it basically dwell a little bit longer. Then I'm gonna come in here and I'm gonna spray it down with a light coat of vinegar to neutralize everything. And then I'm gonna towel over it, and that's gonna be it. I tried it the other day and it works absolutely phenomenal. It works great. And I'm gonna show basically all of these few steps it takes to get this looking like brand new again. With just an Oreck and a towel. Let's see here, comes on when you walk in the door here. And this ceramic tile bathroom here. And this is dirtier than the average bathroom tile. Don't necessarily know why the bathroom tile is as dirty as it is. You see the difference from dirty to where you get clean over here in the corner. We're gonna get like that, a little cleaner everywhere. So it's really odd that you get the bathroom tile this soiled. So I think I'm gonna start in the two bathroom areas first. And like I said, they're gonna get a scrub, some dwell time, a little bit more dwell time, and then they're gonna get a towel rotated over the top of them. The thing about it is if you rotate the towel over the top and you don't neutralize it first, it makes suds. And then your towel basically is ineffective. You know, it won't soak up the suds. So if you spray it with vinegar before you towel it up, you'll just soak everything up and you won't have to do another vinegar rinse on the floor. You can do it in one smooth step here. So let me get my sprayers out. I'm gonna spray both of these guys down, and then I'll pick up the video here. Just a few. Let's spray down. You can see what happens when you get peroxide around any kind of mold or anything. You know, always by the shower, it takes a long time for the grout line to dry. Bathrooms don't get airflow, so you don't get mold in the grout line near the tub or the shower. So also here by the sink. So you can see the areas that have the mold issue, and the peroxide is addressing that. So let's dwell for a little bit. And there's this guy over here. You can see there's a little bit of mold issue over there by the shower and tub again. And everything else is basically just that it's soaking down and it's relying on the high pH. Totally awesome, basically. And the way I've got it mixed is it's a 2 gallon sprayer. So I've got one 32 ounce bottle of the LA Totally Awesome that you saw on the counter with a healthy shot of peroxide, and that's basically it. It's in there. You know, in the event that I felt like I needed a little higher pH and I've got floor stripper on the van, I could add that to it. You know, or I could even add ammonia if I wanted. Next step here, it's going to be to take the Oreck out and scrub it. And then right here is where I've got my vinegar and water mix. That's it, that's all it takes to neutralize it, the vinegar and the water. No matter what you're using, you neutralize liquid Drano with vinegar, and it's not that hard to find either, so.
So far, we haven't spent just a whole lot of money on this this whole thing. So I'm gonna take this guy over here and get this set up to run. And we're gonna scrub it down in a few, and I'll show the scrubbing going on, because that's interesting for a cool minute. So I'll be back. All right, guys. See if I can record this alone. Scrub the floor some more. That is it's odd how that's curious and fun. Thank you. y'all remember earlier, it was Easter Sunday that I did this huge job on this garage style concrete floor inside this computer store here in Austin. It turns out the guy that owns that chain of computer stores also owns 30 rental properties here in town, and they were happy with the way I cleaned, so I got more business. So from Easter Sunday working, I obtained another valuable client. Next thing to do here is to come back and pre-test and make sure that I've got everything coming out of the grout that I expect to be coming out of the grout. So let it dwell for a few more minutes and I'll be back. All right, you see it all sudsy right now. We're getting ready to do some vinegar.
that kills the alkalinity. What we've got. It's just your typical microfiber bonnet. I've got some that are more absorbent than this one, but this one should get the job done. Hopefully, we'll be able to watch it all from here without me watching the camera. This is to avoid using the vacuum for a small area like this. Next step here, I'm gonna get a fan and I'm gonna put that in here to start drying this out. Since it's a dark colored grout, it's difficult to really prove and show how clean it is. So I'm gonna get the fan and start drying it out, and we'll come back and have a look at that in a little bit. believe that is three towels in the bathroom.
Yes, three towels in the bathroom.
I'm going to set the fan up here in this bathroom too and get it to dry, and then we'll come back and have a look at it in a bit.
All right, guys, I'm going to go ahead and have a look at the floor back down there in just a second. I'm going to say,
now keep in mind, this product at Full Tilt retail, it's $1 at Dollar Tree. So if you figure whatever the profit margin is, you know, I would figure this bottle of cleaner might cost Dollar Tree about a quarter to put in the store. So that makes the bottle worth about 20 cents and the cleaner inside worth about a nickel. So the bottle is the most expensive part of any product you buy. No matter where you're buying it, the bottle is the most expensive thing about the cleaner. So the bottle is the most expensive thing about that one as well. Same here. All right, let's go have a look. Fans are on. Start on the kitchen and laundry area, the tile here. So the other thing that I want to add is that, you know, basically what you're trying to do, there's a lot of guys, I don't think you understand how simple it is, you know, what you're trying to do. They think that all of these things come into play and that they're using that doesn't actually do the cleaning for them. They feel like 1500 to 3000 PSI is needed to blast it out of the grout. That's not true. You need basically the cleaner to emulsify the soil that's in the grout. The cleaner does the majority of the work. If you want to, and you had enough time to spend with a towel, I could orbit the towel around. I could up the pH a little bit, probably with floor stripper, and I could run the towel over it, and that would take the soil out of the grout. I would just skip the agitation. And I may do a video on that as well, just to prove my point. But if you get your chemical correct, you don't need anything, not even that much agitation to get the soil out of the grout. It's just how efficiently you can get the product back off the floor and leave it neutral. So, you know, when everybody's trying to sell you a cleaning system, and oh, this one cleans at 1200 PSI, but this one cleans better at 3000 PSI. That's horseshit. You know, if you wanted to do this outside on concrete, you could do it as well, but it just makes more sense to run a pressure washer on concrete, because nobody really runs a pre-spray on concrete in the middle of the hot sun, because it's not gonna stay in solution. It's gonna dry up too fast. So basically you just crank up the PSI and do it all with PSI outside. You don't need the PSI inside where you can get the grout line wet. And cleaning the grout line is exactly the same as cleaning concrete. It's the same thing. You're doing the exact same thing. So you get your cleaning solution right, and then you find the most efficient way of getting it off of the floor. And you've seen me agitate with a tool that's used that costs $150. And then you saw me agitate. What those are bath mats from IKEA. I think they're $3.99 a piece. So that's what I'm cleaning with here today. And I'm neutralizing the vinegar. That costs a couple dollars
Totally Awesome cost $1, and the jug of peroxide cost about $5. So that's what you're seeing me spray down here. I do the cleaning with. So I haven't spent a whole lot of money. And you can do this fast. And what you do to do it fast is you don't record a video and you don't share any of this with anybody, then I can be in and out of here and be done. You know, and it, you clean at the same efficiency as somebody that cleans with a, you know, a $20,000 truck mount inside a $30,000 van with a $1,500 spinner and however much hose and high pressure line it takes to get you to and from the house. And then whatever they spend on those chemicals that they use, which is probably $35 or $50 a gallon. So yeah, those guys are really needing to charge a lot extra for tile in order to be profitable. I don't have anything in it but elbow grease and time, and I'm sharing this with you guys for free. So, you know, there it goes for expensive equipment, you know, and expensive chemicals. I'm showing you how to do it without any of that shit. It's not necessary. So, you know, so when you're looking around for equipment and you're looking around for chemicals and you get in those Facebook groups and somebody's trying to sell you something, think about this guy over here that's not selling you a damn thing, but selling you how to do it for a dollar's worth of chemicals. Think about that. All right, I'm gonna load up my all my sprayers and bring it down here. And I'm gonna pre-spray this tile here. And one thing I'm gonna do different on this one is I'm gonna use my Clark machine to agitate. What's gonna be different when I agitate with a Clark machine is that it's just a rotary. So it's gonna be a little harder to agitate with because the rotary wants to torque on you to the left and right. Whereas with the Orbital, it's rotating in a random fashion and you can clean in a full circle with it and have it not torque on you a bit. So that's what's gonna be different about this one down here. Anyway, I'm gonna get it pre-sprayed and then we're gonna start agitating it with a Clark. So I'll be right back.
I tried to use the rotary, but the brush on it is really soft, so it tries to dive on you. So we're gonna use the Oreck to work with this guy as well.
Never count on the camera guy to show up. somewhere out there, there's one guy thinking Corey didn't do this corner right here. When he came by, I didn't see him do it. These guys have been around for about 20 years under different names. I want to say it was about $15 at Home Depot. It comes with the batteries in it. It's got this edge, and it's also got a straight one, a pointed bristle brush too. That was gonna say something about that. He's always out there somewhere on YouTube looking around for something to complain about. These are non-slip shoes. They're like $32 on Amazon somewhere. One of these days I might put together an Amazon store if I ever find the time and list everything that that you see me using out here. Because everything's available on Amazon. But that's just not a source of my income at this point. It's just been basically get all my income from all my cleaning here. And the video is a byproduct of that, which at some point here, within the next 3 or 4 weeks, will probably start paying me some amount of something for all of this work you see me doing out here, taking time to make a video for everybody to watch and train guys that I don't even know. So, I'm looking forward to that. I think that's pretty fancy. Anyway, I'm gonna get this machine out of here. Then I'm gonna let it basically dwell just a little bit longer. I'm gonna hit it with vinegar, and then I was going to use the shop vac and vacuum it up, but I believe I've changed my mind. I think I'm gonna finish with towels, just for the fact that I started with towels, and I want to break out another tool. I'm gonna clean up with towels as well, and we'll see how many towels it took to do this whole job when I'm done. What I did was, it was a little too much to deal with. So I had to hook up and do a little bit of vacuuming off the floor. I think I may try to find one of these one size smaller, and I've got one at the house to put on the van. Because when you pick up solution, you're not talking with just a little bit. A 1 gallon one of these, I've got one that's 1 gallon that may be enough to hold in one hand and vacuum up everything off the floor. So now, this is how I'm gonna finish it out. I think, now this is too many towels. I don't need this many towels to do what I'm gonna do here. But this is how I'm gonna dry this place out. The last little bit. And if there's any soil left behind, this is what knocks that off. does that one little final final bit of buff and clean that you need. Pick up my towels here, put the fans out, come back and take another look. now and just put everything back in the van. This doesn't live on the van right here. This is going back off when I get home. So the Challenger lives on the van. The Oreck lives in the van. So technically the stuff that I used, this is all my carpet tools here. I've got stretching tools in here. I've got four irons I do my seaming in here with. This guy has got basically all my hand tools in it. This guy here has got basically, it's got a drill. It's got some 18 volt Ryobi batteries in it and an electric 16 gauge brad nailer. And this guy, I picked up something yesterday. It goes in this toolbox, just in this toolbox. I've got a crown stapler, a 16 gauge finish nailer, and a Ryobi 1 gallon. I'll show you in another video, a Ryobi 1 gallon, 18 volt compression tank, basically. So it's got, you can run air tools off of just that one little 1 gallon 18 volt tank. Over here, I've got microfiber towels. We've got 100 of these at home. I've got my cotton underneath there. And then there is all of my, kind of the newer stuff that I'm doing. I've got my white pads and I've got my microfiber bonnets. And these are the microfiber bonnets that have the scrubbing stripe in those guys here. So we'll be using these probably next week at some point. So that's basically everything lives on the van. I've got everything up here. I've been using this a lot more lately. It's just unreal how good that stuff works. And over here is basically the cleaner that I make plant-based laundry detergent. 7 on the pH scale, it's neutral. In case you run into trouble, I've got a gallon of degreaser there. I've got the citrus degreaser there. And I've got 5 gallons of floor stripper there, more vinegar there. So it's this is where my two fans go. They live right there. So anyway, that's about everything. Cooler, can't go anywhere without that. So I'm gonna put the rest of my tools up on the van and then we'll come back and take one more look here at the floor as it's drying up. Sun's kind of coming in funny, so it looks weird, but we'll take one more look before I'm done. All right, guys, we're all done here. Tile and grout is clean as new. It still needs to dry in a few spots, but for the most part, we are clean and dry and ready to put people back in this house. So, just a little bit more drying and corners and stuff, and basically we're done. So one thing about when you clean a tile like this, you show people a lot of imperfections that are in the grout. Some people, you know, you uncover problems they didn't know they had. It happens every once in a while. Turned out good here. Guys, that finishes up this little tile and grout cleaning I did here. I tried to break it up in as many different points as I can to show basically what I was doing. So if you have questions, you're always welcome to it. At the end of the video, you can have some people text me questions if they have them. Other people, you know, they put questions in the comments and stuff. So I'm just doing these videos to help guys out. So if there's anybody trying to sell you all this expensive equipment you need to do grout with, tile and grout with, or carpet, any of that stuff,
The truth is quite the contrary. You don't need expensive equipment to do this work. You need to have a working knowledge of how to do it, but you don't need to have expensive equipment to do it. You know, the only time I would say you need to have, you know, the high pressure system to do this work with is if you plan on doing tile and grout all day long and you have thousands of square feet of it and you have to make really good time and you know you're gonna have enough business to pay off that equipment and make up for all that hose dragging and stuff that you're gonna have to do, because I used to do it that way. It is faster and more efficient, but in order for you to break into business and begin doing that, the startup cost is very expensive and you never know if you're gonna have enough business, you know, to pay for the equipment that you went out and got the loan for. So I appreciate you guys watching the video. If you have questions, you're always welcome to reach out to me. Thanks for watching and God bless. Oh, and also down in the comment section, actually down in the video description, I've got a link that takes you to it's called Stephen Siller Tunnels to Towers Foundation, where they pay for first responders, homes that have died on duty. Basically, it pays off the mortgage for the family. So you can go down there and donate if you want. Thanks for watching. God bless.